future. The best is still yet to come for you. There is a king in you. Let the ruler rule. I know you've been through. I know you've been through. But there is a king. Embrace your king. And
there is a king.
Hey, hey. Just one more time, y'all. Embrace your king, everybody. Over here, embrace your king. Embrace your king. Life has made you feel bad about yourself. I know that some of the things you've been through has made you feel bad about yourself. But you need to know that there is a ruler in you. There is what has happened. The enemy has tricked you and made you feel like that you are beneath. He's tricked you and made you feel like that you are a borrower and never will be a lender. But Donald Lawrence came to tell you that there is a king in you. There is a king in you. There is a king in you. I can't stress it enough. There is a king living in you. Rule, ruler, rule. Speak, king, speak. Stand, king, stand. Take control, king, take control. Rule, rule, rule. You have dominion.
34 minutes past the hour here on 91.9 FM. WLJS Jacksonville. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Late Night with Edmore III. Tonight, we'll be discussing stepfamilies, the dynamics, the ins and outs. How do stepfamilies operate, the positives and negatives with stepfamily relationships, as well as the relationships between stepparents and biological parents. How does that work? How does that operate? As I said in the show earlier, I've come from a family who... I've never personally had a step-parent type relationship. And so I always had this interest, this curiosity to know what step-families were like in this country. And how do we break the stigma, break the stereotypes that go with having a step-family or a step-parent or a step-sibling? So I have two individuals here. Who will help me discuss just that. Meet my first guest of the evening. His name is Robert A. Spears. He's a 19-year-old college sophomore from San Diego, California. Robert currently has a stepmother, a stepsister, and he used to have a stepfather. And his biological parents, according to him, have been divorced since he was a child. Hello to you, Robert, and welcome to WLJS Studios.
How you doing, Ed?
It's such a pleasure to have you here.
It's and a meet pleasure to be on the show.
Absolutely, absolutely. And please meet my other guest for the evening, Mars Sags. Mars is 19 years old, and he is a college sophomore as well from New Orleans, Louisiana. Mars currently has a stepfather and a stepsister, and he, although used to have a stepmother, he is still extremely close with her, according to him. And his biological parents divorced when he says he was around the age of 8 years old. Hello to you, Mars, and welcome.
Good night, Ed. How you doing?
And welcome to the show. Such a pleasure to have you two here. Well, gentlemen, as you know, tonight we're going to be discussing step families and the dynamics of such. One thing that I want to get off, to go ahead and just kind of put it out there for tonight, is what are some of the stigmas and some of the stereotypes that come along with having a step family or a mixed family or family from other places Just go ahead and let our listening audience know what some of those are.
Have things like civil family feuds. You're going to hate your stepmom. You're going to hate your stepsister. Just family members not getting along, playing favorites. I mean, it's all there.
Mm-hmm. Mars, what do you want to tell our listening audience about some of the stigmas that come along with step families and some of the stereotypes that come along with step families?
Well, basically the same as Robert said, you know, parents playing favorites, parents not paying attention to, you know, the stepchild or the biological child, you know, evil stepmother type deal.
Mm.
All, you know, all that.
Mm-hmm.
A terrible Cinderella story.
The terrible Cinderella story. So the evil stepmother, or the mean stepfather, the mean and abusive stepfather, and you have the wicked, mean, and not even necessarily in the fairy tale type essence, but in real life essence, that step families are mean, or that they're cruel, or that there is no love, or there's no care. I want to know, is that true amongst the two of you all's step families? It's not true?
Definitely not.
Why is it not true? Why? How does it go against that stereotype, or how does it go against that rhetoric?
Well, my stepmom, she doesn't play favorites at all. If one of us acts up, she'll tell one of us to chill out. If one of us does something good, or both of us do something good, then she's going to treat us both the same in praising us for our good behavior.
Okay. Mars, how does your step family go against? And Mars, you actually have a stepfather currently. Yes. And you used to have a stepmother. Your father was married to another woman, and they've divorced, but you are still very close with her. How does that work with her? Although she used to be your stepmother, but you're still very close to her. What is you all's relationship like?
I mean, it's still basically the same as it was when they were married. I don't treat her any different. I actually don't even think about it when, you know, we're all around. It doesn't really click in my mind unless someone mentions it.
Absolutely.
I still treat her exactly the same, you know, love her the same, even though they did divorce and everything. It really isn't that awkward. If you know, you think it would be kind of awkward, like she's kind of, since she isn't really blood, and since they divorced, there's really not any ties. But you know, she's been my stepmom since about when my mom and my real dad broke up. They got married shortly after, so she's been around for a very long time, and there still is a, you know, relationship there between my brother and her. We still consider her, you know, our stepmom, even though they're divorced.
Okay. I wanted to know, you all, and this is something that I've always had a curiosity and an interest of. When it comes to discipline, you get in trouble and someone has to be the authority figure. Someone has to lay down the law that a particular behavior of yours or a particular act of yours was unacceptable. Does the step parent have to ask the biological parent for permission to discipline you, whether it be something such as a spanking or a whooping? We've all gotten those before. I know I did growing up. Is there an instance where the step parent has to ask the biological parent for permission, or is it not that case? I've always been curious about that.
My stepdad, I mean, growing up as a child, I never really was, you know, the mischievous type, I guess. I was sort of passive, docile. I really never got into any trouble. You know, they'd, you know, be like, okay, you can't play your video games or all that. You know, go to your room, and I sort of just listened. I never really questioned him, and, you know, regardless of who it was punishing me, they sort of didn't ever need to ask either one's permission to punish me. With my stepmom or my stepdad,
absolutely
asking my biological parent, it was sort of just, an unspoken rule almost that, you know, I need to give them my respect. Even though they aren't my real parent, they are acting in place as that parent.
As a parent.
So I need to respect them as if they are that parent.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and what about you, Robert? You currently have a stepmother. Does your stepmother have to ask, even though I know you're 19 years old now, you're an adult, but when you were, even when you were younger, growing up as a child and as a teenager, and did your stepmother have to ask permission from your biological father to discipline you or to straighten you out, as some people would say it, in any way?
Well, she didn't really have to ask, but if I would get into trouble, she would make sure my dad, like, just knew what was going on. Mm-hmm. Not to say, you know, I disciplined Robert today, and, you know, I think you should do something about it. But it's more like, I disciplined Robert this way, and this is what happened. She doesn't really have to ask permission, but there's still that line of communication that they have with each other.
Yeah. Sort of let each other know that, you know, I had to talk to him about this today, you know, he cut school today, all that. They still tell each other they're not gonna, you know, punish, you know, either me or my brother or something, and not tell the other one.
Yeah.
They always let each other know before or after they did something.
In other words, there's no deceit, there's no hiding, or
yeah.
You
yeah,
know
exactly.
They didn't discipline you and then not say anything.
Yeah.
There was always, okay, so there's an open line of communication. What about you get in trouble at school and someone has to be called? Someone has to be called to the school to come pick you up. We're talking about high school. And you're in the office and the secretary asks you, who do you want me to call?
My dad.
You call dad? Okay. Would you call your dad first, or let's just say if you knew he wasn't available, would you wait to call him, or would you just go ahead and call your stepmother?
Well, I would call my dad, and the only reason why I would call my dad is because my stepmom, she can't have her phone on while she's at work.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she's an optometrist, so she's going to be working with patients, so mm-hmm. she can't deal with a cell phone. So I know my dad would be able to have a likely chance of answering his phone over my stepmom.
Over your stepmother. What about you, Mars? You're in high school, let's just say you're in the 9th or 10th grade, and you have gotten in trouble and they have to call somebody. You currently have a stepmother. Would you call her or would you call your father? And why?
I would actually call my dad, because we've just had, nothing against the relationship between me and my stepmother, but me and my dad have had a longer relationship, and, you know, even with my mom and my stepdad, my biological parent was the first one I'd always go to, because that's the first person I'd think of calling, you know. Gotta call mom, gotta call dad, you know, something happened. And if they didn't pick up, I wouldn't wait for them to pick up. I'd immediately call, you know, stepdad or stepmom. No disrespect to them or anything, but
absolutely,
it's just the first thing that comes to my mind is, you know, call mom, you know, call dad, and then, you know, it's call Bill or call Kim.
Mm.
You know, they're not picking up. So,
And you have two step parents. Is this correct, Mars? You have a stepmother that your father remarried to, and you also have a step father
yes.
that your mother remarried to. So you have one on one end and one on the other. Is there ever any type of awkwardness or confusion having so many parental units at one time like that?
Not at all. No, not at all.
Never. There's never been. And that's another thing too that I know some people wonder about. Is there ever, when you all have the family reunions and everyone is there together, you got the stepmother, the stepfather, then you got the biological parents, you got the biological mother, you got the biological father, is there ever any awkwardness, or is it just the one big loving family?
I mean, it's more of a one big loving family.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's just like my graduation, you know, I had
everybody was there.
Mom, sister, niece, nephew, everybody. So it's like they're wasn't any awkwardness. They all sat together. We all ate afterwards, you know.
Really does go against the stereotype of bickering step families. Really,
I
mean, does.
The only reason why they would bicker is